hell's
that? Sounds like another rat.
God, come on.
Stupid.
Bugger off, pal. Just bugger off or I'll smash your face.
And you know where that'll get you?
It'll get rid of you for starters.
Why have you stopped?
Shut up!
Mama!
Just shut up!
Mama,
let me think!
You and Smart must be pretty good friends for you to risk something like this. Attempted escape, assaulting an officer, they'll throw the key away.
I'm gonna lose then, have I?
Just put that down and there'll be no assault charge. Come on, it's up to you.
Never get here.
I hope you have a good explanation for this, Smith.
I'll explain what's going on here, Mrs. Davidson, if you explain why Helen Smart's in the pound.
Mr. Fawkner, take Smith to my office. Mrs. Morris, Officer Sharp, would you go to the workroom, please? Mrs. Ward is there by herself.
Come on, Smith, move it.
Well, I hope this hasn't all been for nothing.
Davidson, here's the reason for the disturbance. Caught Gaffney trying to break into solitary with them.
What were you trying to achieve, Gaffney?
Very well, bring her to my office, Mrs. Powell.
Carol Lewis is due in court this morning. I did promise Jennifer I'd be there.
Oh, yes, of course. Well, off you go. We can manage.
Come along, Gaffney.
Now, Gaffney, explain what you were doing in solitary.
The noise was getting too much for me. I wanted to find somewhere quiet.
Oh, all right, cut it out. Maybe this is our chance to get an answer to a few questions. Mrs. Davidson, we want to know why you've got...
I'll ask the question, Smith. It's about time you realise the prisoners do not run Wentworth. Now, I would like to know why you were carrying on like this.
All right, I'll tell you why. Because we were stupid enough to think there was some justice left in this world.
Meaning?
Meaning you've got Helen Smart locked in solitary and you've lost the key.
It's for her own protection.
Baldust!
Shut up. Protection? Who are you protecting her from, us?
As you very well know, there were drugs involved.
There were drugs involved because some bigwig called Stanfield had them set up in Helen's flat.
Do you have any proof of that?
No, none. And we can never get any unless someone can help her. But what chance has she got? Stanfield's got everyone on the payroll. Even her solicitor backed out the minute she mentioned his name.
She had a solicitor at her hearing.
Oh, someone she met 5 minutes before the trial. That's terrific. She needs him now, Mrs. Davidson. Helen has been in solitary for 4 days. Now, that's not legal. Well, maybe you're getting a secret pay packet as well.
How dare you say that?
Why shouldn't I? At least you can defend yourself. Helen can't.
Mr. Fawkner, take them back.
Come on.
And then assemble all the women in the recreation room.
Yes, ma'am.
I'll be there shortly.
Come on, move it.
Julie? Would you get Helen Smart's solicitor on the phone, please?
Well, you were a lot of use. You could have at least said something.
No need. I agree with Mrs. Davidson. I think you're mad trying what you did.
Helen needs help, and how the hell is she going to get it to the authorities? Don't give it to her. Didn't you hear a word I said in there?
The evidence against
us was rigged. Now, we could prove that with outside help. Are you with us or against us?
Is everything all right?
Yes. How's the workroom? Any trouble?
No, it's all quiet there. I'm just going to report to Mrs. Davidson. Is she in her office?
Yes, she is, but not for long. She wants to speak to the women in the rec room.
Well, I better hurry.
Go on, move it.
Yes, I'm afraid I agree with you. Well, thank you for your time, Mr. Saunders. Goodbye. Yes?
I just want to report that law and order has been restored and everything's quiet.
Well, I wonder if it will stay that way when they hear what Helen Smart's solicitor had to say.
Is that what all this is about? Helen Smart?
Yes, I'll tell you on the way to the recreation room. And in future, I suggest you all think more carefully before doing anything quite so stupid again.
Why is Helen Smart still in the pound?
Of course, I realize it may have been one person's idea and that the rest of you were all forced into going along with it. Nevertheless, you will all be punished. Perhaps it will make you think for yourselves and not play follow the leader.
Well, that's not true, Mrs. Davidson. We all did have a hand in it. No one let us. And we'll all keep doing it again until Helen Smart gets a fair go.
I said that's enough, Judy.
It's quite all right, Mrs. Morris. Bryant, what makes you think that Smart was not getting a fair go?
You gotta be kidding. First of all, her trial was fixed. Then she's bunged into solitary so she can't appeal. I bet her solicitor doesn't know about it.
Well, that's where you're quite wrong. I have just spoken to her solicitor.
And?
He informed me that on the evidence presented at her trial, she has no hope of getting an appeal.
Sorry I'm late. There was trouble at work.
Oh, it's all right. They're running a bit late here, too.
How are you feeling? Not nervous, are you?
A little.
Oh, sure, you're right. All you've got to do is get up and tell the truth, darling.
Dad says she'll be right once more. I'll scream.
It will be all right.
Dad.
Listen. Whatever happens, you're not going to forget what they did to you, are you?
I can't forget what he did to me, Mum. How can I? He would have killed me if Carol hadn't.
Look, that's what you mustn't say because they won't understand. They'll make her out to be some sort of hero, don't you see that?
What? Lie, Mum?
Of course you won't. That's not...
All rise. All persons having business before this honourable court, stand nigh and you shall be heard. God save the Queen.
The first case in the list is the Attorney General against Caroline Frances Lewis. I've been informed that the charge of murder has been withdrawn and a charge of manslaughter substituted in its place. I'm further advised that the defendant has decided to plead guilty to this charge. Is that correct, Mr. Barton?
Yes, Your Honour. They are my instructions.
In that case, I see no further impediment in this matter. I'm in your hands, Mr. Prosecutor.
I wish to call Mr. Peter Keogh.
Call Mr. Peter Keogh.
But if there's no grounds for an appeal, that's it, isn't it? I mean, Mrs. Davidson wouldn't lie, would she?
Well, that's not the point. If we could get someone on the outside to have a look at Helen's bank account, she'd get an appeal so fast and make your head spin. But don't worry, I haven't given up yet. Hell, we haven't even started.
Hi.
What's all this then?
Ta-da! Oh, a big bucket of beautiful booze.
Yeah, and guess
who carried it all the way here from the boiler room while Tinkerbell here struggled under the enormous weight of 12 empty plastic bottles.
Stop moaning and watch the door.
Plastic bottles. Now, where did you get those from?
Oh, well, see, I knew you'd all be dying for a drink, so I didn't think you'd mind if I emptied the shampoo out of your bottles.
Oh, oh. I feel like
well,
a rinse.
What else was a girl to do?
Faulkner.
Oh. Oh, put it in the dryer, quick. Oh, well, well, if it isn't the department's yes man.
All right, B, that's enough. You don't play fair, do you? I have helped you in the past.
Play fair? Look here, Mr. Fawkner. We may be no angels, but at the moment you've got a woman in solitary who's really innocent.
How do you know she's innocent?
How do you know she's guilty?
She's been tried in a court.
Set up, you mean? Just let us get a pen and paper to Helen and watch the fur fly. Well, do you want to be a yes man all your life?
Let's put it this way. I can't report it if I don't see it, can I?
Well, what use is that? How can we get to her in solitary?
That's your problem. All right, ladies, move out to lunch.
He wasn't much help.
Oh, bugger all. Unless I missed his point. Well, I don't think I did.
Well, how are we going to get to her in solitary?
Precisely. I mean, he's not going to help us, is he? He's just like all the rest of them. Mm.
Oh, bum. This place is getting to be too much like hard work.
What do you mean?
Oh, well, first the booze and now Helen. I don't know what's going on.
Well, what's wrong with the booze? It works, doesn't it?
Yeah, but too good. We've got gallons of the stuff and I've got nowhere to put it.
Oh. Well, what about Judy's idea? I'm putting it in the fire extinguisher.
Oh, she was kidding. You couldn't... You bloody could, you know. Come on.
Joke, Doreen. I didn't mean it.
You're not listening to me. I said all I have to do is get that big spanner thing from the workshop.
Multi-grips.
Yeah, those two. And take the top off the fire extinguisher.
It won't work. Not with those multi-grips.
Well, why not?
They're too small. Look, there's a way of doing it. I know how to do it. I'll fix it.
Okay? You just make sure you clean it out first.
Of course I will. What do you think I am?
Shower block.
What?
We can take Mr. Fawkner up on his offer.
How?
Well, they take Helen for a shower every morning, right?
Yeah, but they don't take her until we're finished. We wouldn't see her.
We leave the pen and paper in one of the cubicles.
It'd get wet.
Wrapped in a plastic bag.
What about the screws?
That, my little chickadee, is where Mr. Nice Guy Fawkner comes in. Mm.
Well, what if it all goes wrong and she goes into the wrong cubicle?
It won't if you get me those multi-grips.
What if I can't get them?
Bloody hell, Doreen, you were ready enough to get them when you thought it was for your precious booze. Now, isn't Helen more important?
Yeah, she is, of course.
Well, don't get sprung, because too much depends on...
All right, ladies, mail call. Susie, yours looks important. Read the handies out, please.
A telegram? Are you sure it's for me?
Well, that's what it says. Susie Driscoll.
Who can it be from?
Well, you won't know till you read it.
Please make arrangements. Re-employment interview as soon as possible. We did it!
I seem to be the only one that doesn't know what's going on.
Oh, sorry, Mrs. M. I applied for this job at a fast food service, and B wrote the letter.
That's terrific, Susie. Congratulations.
Yeah, oh, good on you, kid.
Thanks. Oh, but what if I don't get out in time?
Oh, I'm sure we can arrange a half-day release for you. You let me have this and I'll speak to Mrs. Davidson.
Oh, thanks. But can I have it back, please? I've never had a telegram before.
And did her husband, this madman as you called him, did he ever leave the house?
Yes.
For any length of time?
I think so. I can't remember exactly.
And in his absence, did Carol Lewis make any attempt to set you free?
She couldn't. He would have killed her.
Couldn't? Why? Did he have the only key to your room?
No.
Or was your room locked?
Yes.
All the time?
I think so.
But you're not sure?
No.
But you are sure that he left you with only his wife to guard you, and knowing he was capable of killing, knowing he had already killed, she still made no attempt to set you free.
I told you he would have killed her.
Just answer the question, Miss Powell. Yes or no?
No.
Thank you, Miss Powell.
Tell me, Miss Powell, in her husband's absence, did Carol Lewis do anything to assist you?
Oh, yes. She knew how frightened I was, so she used to sit and talk to me. That's when I found out she was scared of him too.
Scared of her own husband?
Well, she didn't exactly say that, but I could tell. She said something about him not being well. And then there was a time when she rang Mum to let her know I was all right.
Oh, she was scared of him, and yet she did that. Now, why?
I asked her to. I felt awful when he caught her. He kept hitting her. I didn't think he was ever going to stop.
Did that stop her helping you?
No. She just had to be more careful.
Thank you, Miss Powell. That'll be all.
You may stand down, Miss Powell. Well, that seems a convenient place for an adjournment. This court will reconvene at 10 o'clock tomorrow morning.
All rise. This court stands adjourned.
Pen and paper?
Yeah, you got the plastic bag?
Yeah.
Now, don't get lumbered with them, because they'll know where they came from. And why aren't you all carrying your shampoo bottles? You don't want the screws to wake up, do you?
How come you didn't empty yours down the sink?
Because it's a new full bottle.
Then there's plenty for all of us, isn't there? Isn't that generous of her, Judy?
Oh, yeah, she's all heart.
Okay, where's the fire?
Mrs. Morris has fixed everything up. I'm going for the interview this morning.
Oh, great. Good on you, kid.
How could you tell me?
What I
just
told
wish she'd slow down.
Well, that's Susie fixed up. Now let's concentrate on Helen.
Hmm. Any of that lime marmalade left, love?
It's in the cupboard.
I'm not going to call you again, Robert. Come and have your breakfast.
Which cupboard, love?
Oh, for heaven's sake, it's just there.
Okay.
Well, we'll all be able to relax a bit better after today, eh?
Yeah, including Carol Lewis. After yesterday's episode, I wouldn't be surprised if they made a woman of the year. Here you are. Want any more? You'll have to do it yourselves. I've got to get ready.
I only told the truth, Mum. I told you I wouldn't lie.
Yes, I know, darling. It's just that I hope... Well, I hope they do the right thing.
Of course they will. Doesn't matter anyway. Main thing is we've got our scruffy kid back.
Robert! Oh, hurry up, ladies. You're slow as a wet week.
It won't be a jiff.
I don't think much of your shampoo, Doreen.
Yeah, no TV commercials for me this week.
Well, you didn't have to use it.
Can I go, Mrs. Morris? I don't want to be late.
No, just wait here. We won't be long.
You go on. We'll catch up.
Yeah, you go ahead. You don't want to be late for your first day.
All right, then. But don't be long. Now, hurry up, ladies. Come on, move it.
Oh, Susie, walk. Don't run.
Under these taps.
Oh, the rest is up to Helen.
What's happening, huh?
Yeah. Oh, hell, I forgot to wish the brat good luck. Come on.
How can I go to an interview dressed like this? Everything's too small.
Susie, it's not that bad. Besides, there's nothing we can do about it now. Now, come on, sign out and let's get going.
Well, it's not fair. I'm going to look like a real freak. Oh, I bet no one else goes to an interview like this. I mean, they're not even mine. They're secondhand. Oh, it's terrific, isn't it? I'm really going to make a good impression turning up like this.
Susie!
Oh, well, well, well. Surprise, surprise. There's nobody here either. Ever get the feeling your deodorant isn't doing its job? Officer Sharp, I might get you to scrub my back a little later on. I mean, you are a miss, aren't you? You're not married or anything.
Travel.
What's up?
after speaking to Angie, and she saw Helen go into the showers and Fawkner wasn't with her.
Oh, hell, he's always been with her every other morning.
Yeah, I know. What do you reckon, B?
Well, it could still work as long as the screw doesn't go into the cubicle. Who was with her?
Sharp.
Ah, good. She usually stays out in the corridor. I reckon we'll be okay. You can relax, ladies.
Oh, Beauty, give us a hand with this, will you, Margaret?
Hey, Bev, better keep a look out at the door.
Oh, that's wonderful, isn't it?
What's wrong?
It's bloody empty. What'd happen if there was a fire?
We'd all go up in flames. Now, come on, hurry up. Complain to the department later.
Hey.
This has been a strange case, as I'm sure the court will agree. The crimes of abduction, assault, and rape repulse me, as they do every decent and law-abiding citizen. But we have dealt with these and are now left with the charge of manslaughter. While this court can never condone the unlawful taking of a human life, it must also take note and act on the unfortunate circumstances in this case. The accused undoubtedly suffered years of mental and physical abuse at the hands of her husband, and yet she had courage enough to defy him on more than one occasion in order to protect a young girl, the unfortunate victim in this case, Miss Jennifer Powell. Miss Powell has strongly defended the accused and praised her courage in no uncertain terms, and this the court must recognize. Caroline Frances Lewis, you have been found guilty by a jury of your peers of the charge of manslaughter, and this court sentences you to 3 years' imprisonment to be served concurrently with your other sentences.
This is the new waitress uniform. You look great in one of these, Susie.
Do you mean I've really got the job?
Susie, when I first read your application, I thought this girl's got nous, and that's what we need at the chuck wagon. So if you're paroled...
That's just terrific. Could we have the job offer in writing for the parole board?
I don't think there's any need to bother with that, Mrs. Morris, but I'll tell you what I will do. Step in here, Davy. You've heard about Susie?
Oh, yeah.
This is Mrs. Morris.
Mrs. Morris?
Dave Goodman's our top photographer, and he's here to take a photograph of myself and Susie for the company records.
Glad to meet you. Now, Susie, if you could just step in front of the desk here. That's right. Now, with Mr. Strawn in there. Yeah.
Mr. Strawn.
This'll only take a minute, and I promise you the parole board will get a copy. After all, Mrs. Morris, one picture's worth a thousand words.
Right. I'm sorry. I insist on the offer being in writing. The parole board aren't going to accept a picture as proof of anything.
Hold on, Dave. This is to certify that Susan Driscoll will be employed by this company at the time of her parole. Signed, Arthur T. Strawn. Satisfactory?
Thank you.
Now, Susie, big smile.
Right. This won't take a minute. And beautiful.
Beauty!
mother's milk.
How do you feel now that it's all over?
Relieved, I guess. And grateful to Jenny Powell. It was because of her I got the light sentence.
Yes, I heard the news. You were very lucky.
Yes.
These are the authorizations for transfers to Barnhurst, Mr. Fawkner.
Margo Gaffney?
Yes, I'm tired of her gambling activities here. The other one's for you, Lewis.
You're sending me to Barnhurst? Why? Oh, Mrs. Powell. Yeah, she didn't look too happy when she heard about the sentence. Mind you, I don't blame her. If it was my daughter, I'd feel the same.
It has nothing to do with Mrs. Powell. Now that you've been sentenced, you've been classified like any other prisoner. Barnhurst is a lower security establishment.
Yeah, of course.
I'll leave you to handle it, Mr. Fawkner.
Be with you a minute, and I'll take you through. Well, how'd you go?
Can I tell him?
Of course you can. It's not a secret.
I got the job in writing.
Journalism?
Oh, no, he just wrote down he'd give me a job.
Oh, that's great.
Sign in, Susan.
All I've got to do is wait for my parole. Oh, did you hear, Carol?
Yeah, it's great.
Oh, Mr. Strawn, he's the manager of the place. He said he'd give me a job as soon as I got out of here. And you should see the uniform I've got to wear. This skirt, and it's really short. Shorter than this one.
Sign in, please, Susie. If you finish with Carol, I'll take them both through.
Thanks. I'll see you for coffee later.
Fine. Come on, girls, you're wasting the recreation time. And you both got to change.
Oh, I've never thought much about clothes before. Oh, wearing a uniform all the time. As soon as I get
Come
paid,
on,
that's the first thing I'm going to do.
Bruce coming on lovely. I just had a nip when I was checking up on the still.
Yeah, how much is a nip?
What do you mean?
I reckon you probably had a quart. That's what I mean.
I hardly wet me lips.
Oh.
How'd you go?
Good. 3 years, 18 months minimum at Barnhurst.
Oh, well, Barnhurst is far enough away from Powell. She'd try and make 18 months feel like 18 years if she got the chance. Do you fancy a hand?
Yeah.
What'd you get?
Mind you, I don't blame Powell. If I was in her shoes, I'd be just as upset.
Yes, but you wouldn't be in the position to do anything about it, would you?
Yeah, and when you get to Barnhurst, don't give our love to Mari Winter.
Yeah, let's have a couple of snorts to celebrate the news.
Susie's got more to celebrate than I have. She's got a job.
Beauty, where is she?
She's just getting changed.
Oh, then we've got to have a gargle. Congratulations, love. Carol just told us the news.
Go on, kid.
Thanks. I wouldn't have got it if you hadn't written the article. I'm still a bit worried about my parole.
Oh, look, they won't dare stop you now. If they do, B will get onto him with another article, won't you, B?
What do you mean you don't trust him? Susie does have the job.
Oh, yes, yes, I saw to that. No, it was his manner I didn't like.
How do you mean?
Ever bought a used car?
I'm beginning to get the picture.
Well, since that article of B's came out, Susie could become quite a publicity gimmick. And I'd hate to see people taking advantage of her.
There's nothing much you can do about it if they are. She's got to have that job if she wants to get parole.
Oh, yes, I know that. Colleen, didn't expect to see you in today.
Well, isn't hard work supposed to help you forget? Heard what they gave her?
Yes.
18 months. She abducts my daughter. She stands back while that pig attacks her, and they give her 18 months. At least Jennifer was happy for her. Like a father, wouldn't know what bitterness is. Wish to God I didn't.
We're going to have to watch her until Lewis is transferred. She's pretty cut up.
Yeah. I know that feeling well. I think she'll get over it.
There's just three things you have to worry about at Barnhurst. And they're Vera Bennett, Mari Winter and the mushrooms. And believe me, this is the voice of experience talking.
Oh, I'll be all right. They breed them tough, right?
Just sit down.
Just gave me a bit of a shock. I didn't expect you to be here today.
Yeah, I'll keep thinking of Barnhurst.
Oh, pal, looks like a death adder. Keep your chin up, love. Don't let her get to you.
I think that's going to be up to us.
Do you spell criminal with a E-L or a O-L?
With a A-L.
Doesn't look right.
Doreen, how can it look right when you're sitting it back to front?
Oh, yeah.
I thought you got today off because of the trial.
Yeah, B reckons I should stick around you lot.
But you reckons there's safety in numbers.
Yeah? Well, what do you think she'd do?
Just about anything, I reckon.
So we're going to make sure Carol's got plenty of company.
Never had so many people looking after me.
Yeah, what's the name of the game around here?
Hey!
It's so easy snitching stuff for Mrs. O'Regan, I feel almost guilty.
What did you get?
Everything except her bloomers, and she didn't feel a thing. Oh, it's criminal.
Show us.
Well, here. Biscuits, fags.
What sort of biscuits?
Everything. Fruit and the booze.
Oh, Lizzie, I hope you haven't been sampling that again. Remember what I told you?
Don't you worry about me, and I'll get everything set up in the rec room, and it'll be lovely.
What's this, a stop work meeting?
Oh, no, I just popped in to say hello to me mates.
We hurried up then.
Oh, God, get the woman run off her feet.
You having any problems with this?
No, not anymore. It's a breeze.
I thought you weren't working today, Lewis.
Just keeping busy.
Anything wrong, Mr. Fawkner?
Oh, no, I just sort of hang around for a while. It's almost knock-off time.
Yourself?
What's he doing?
Looks like we're not the only ones keeping an eye on you.
Well, that's something anyway.
You reckon? If even the screws think I'm in danger, you can bet I am.
It's looking lovely. Oh, about time we had a party. If any of the screws come in, get rid of the booze.
Okay.
Well, where are the buggers?
Here we are. And just watch who you're calling buggers.
Yeah, and what do you have to do to get a drink around here? Yeah. Help yourself.
Hey.
Listen, so strong.
Only the first one's real smooth after you've had a few.
Believe me, she's had a few.
Well, it certainly clears your nostrils.
Yeah, but it closes one eye.
Can I try one?
Well, it's your party, but I suggest you water it down with something.
Yeah, maybe you could put some turps in it. That'd take the edge off it.
Oh, I'll take the edge off you if you don't stop complaining.
That's good.
Better than any brew these parkers have had for a long while.
Hey, Lil, keep an eye on the door for screws, will you? This is strictly invitation only.
Yeah. And I'd like to make a toast to our little mate, Susie. We're going to miss you, love. We all love you.
Oh, me too. Oh, you're like a real family. Only better.
Yeah. And to Carol, good luck with vinegar tits.
Oh,
yeah.
I'll be all right. I'll knock off a bit of Lizzie's brew. I'll be able to handle anything.
Yeah. Oh, for she's a jolly good fellow. For she's a jolly good fellow.
Corridor. We're just having a little farewell party for Carol and Susie.
Where did this food come from?
We had the caterers in.
It's been stolen from the kitchen.
No, Mrs. Powell, honest, we all put in from our buy-up so that we could give Carol and Susie a good send-off.
Who gave you permission to have a party?
Well, we've got us some fruit and a few lousy biscuits, and we're singing some songs. Now, why would we need permission to do that?
Because the party is unauthorised. Now, get this mess cleaned up and report to yourselves. Do it, ladies, or you'll all be on a 24-hour loss of privileges.
We've just finished work. We're entitled to a recreation period.
And you'll get a recreation period in your cells. Now clean this up. Lewis, you too. It's your party, isn't it?
Yeah, it beats me how you can get around with a chip that size on your shoulder.
You should have quit while you're ahead. You're on an insubordination charge.
One at every party.
Well, she's not going to spoil my party. I'm going to have a nightcap in me room.
Well, it looks like you're almost out of the woods. I probably should be out after breakfast.
Yeah. Thanks for sticking by me.
Lousy luck about the party, eh? Bloody old cow.
I wanted to talk to her sometimes, you know, try and explain what happened, but she gets this look on her face.
Oh, she's been really nice to me. Oh, but I know what you mean about the look.
You keep clear of her.
Ah, Susie.
Look, I'm afraid you'll have to hurry things along. The parole ward's already started. Carol, you'll be transferred out straight after breakfast.
Thanks, Mrs. Morris.
Come on, finish your breakfast.
I can't eat any more, Mrs. Morris. My tummy's all gone like topsy-turvy.
I don't think you've got anything to worry about. Well, come on, let's go.
We'll keep our fingers crossed for you.
Yeah, good luck, kid.
Bye-bye, Susie.
Bye. Oh, I'm scared.
Don't worry, you'll be all right.
Guess I should say my goodbyes to everyone. Where's Lizzie?
Beats me. I saw her at muster.
Yeah, I did too. She said she was feeling crook, probably had a headache, said she couldn't face breakfast.
I could hardly blame her for that.
Some cover for me. I'm going to see if Helen's appearing for us in the shower block. I'll see you before you go.
Come on, hurry up, smart. This isn't a beauty parlour.
Probably just as well, Mrs. Powell. You'd never hold down the job.
Your time's up.
Right, well, all finished. I think a girl should take time with herself, don't you? For her appearance, I mean. But then again, I guess there are times when nothing works.
Move it. Speed it up, Smart. The others will be out of the dining room in a minute. Just a minute.
Oh, make up your mind.
Lizzie? Lizzie, are you okay? Oh, hell. Okay, Birdsworth. Up. Come on, wake up.
Oh, God. Oh, my head.
And whose fault is that? Come on, get up.
Mrs. Powell. I know what you're thinking.
Right.
But you're wrong.
Oh, you're rotten drunk, Birdsworth.
No, Mrs. Powell. I'm just terribly, terribly tired.
Oh, God. Birdsworth is drunk in a cell.
Oh. Good luck to you both.
Thanks, Mrs. Davison.
We'll be out in a minute. Here are the transfers. All right, let's go.
Mrs. Powell, I'd like...
Forget it.
I'm sorry.
Better see to Birdsworth.
Of course.
Mrs. Davidson.
Lizzie.
I think so.
Here, it was in the shampoo bottle. Smell it.
This is distilled spirit, Lizzie. Where did you get it?
Oh, they make shampoo out of some very funny stuff these days, Mrs. Davidson.
What's going on?
Smell that.
It smells bad enough to be homemade.
I want a thorough cell search done immediately. If that liquor was produced inside Wentworth, I want to know how. When you find out, I'll be with the parole board in my office.
Oh. How'd you go? Did you get it?
Yeah, it was taped to the back of the door. It's a full authorization giving the dispatch access to her bank accounts.
Show me.
I haven't got it on, ma'am. I'm taking any chances. I've hidden it in the dorm.
Mm. All right, back to cells. All of you.
What's going on?
Cell search. I'll move.
Looking for what?
We'll know that when we find it, won't we? Come on. Come on, hurry up.
What do you think they're looking for?
I'll give you one guess.
Not the letter. How do they know about that?
Who knows? Maybe Helen slipped up.
I'll go get it back before they search the dorm. We've got to distract them.
How?
Think of something. A fire.
Oh, not another one.
Line up outside yourselves.
Come on.
Susan's case has been carefully considered by the board, and for the most part, everything's in order.
For the most part? I thought Susie's file indicates that she complies with all the board's requirements for parole.
It does. But unfortunately, the board is troubled by one factor. And this concerns her prospective employment.
But that's assured. You've got a copy of the job offer for Mr. Storm.
Yes, we've noted that. And in addition, we've noted this somewhat extravagant advertisement for the food chain that's agreed to employ Susan.
At the chuck wagon, we care for people as we care for food. Doesn't say much.
That's obviously a photograph of Susan. And that, I take it, is Mr. Strawn.
Yes, but this isn't Susie's fault. I mean, I can't see how this affects her. The job has been offered to her. I mean, she can't be held responsible for this advertisement.
Of course not, Mrs. Morris. But the board's responsible for Susan's well-being. This advertisement gives cause for serious concern as to what sort of people are offering her a job.
I know, but I wasn't expecting a cell search.
Right, take Bryant's cell, I'll do Smith's.
That is must have been burning, can't you, Doreen?
What are you talking about?
Oh, Mrs. Powell, it's real strong.
Yeah. Mr. Fawkner! Mr. Fawkner!
Get him out of the corridor.
Well, that's finally becoming second nature to him.
Mm. Hey, the extinguisher. The one with the booze in it.
Oh, hell, the whole place will go up.
This is bloody useless. Get another extinguisher.
Get out! Let me
used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too, when morning comes around. Last night I dreamed we were together, sharing